we are delighted to have you today here, but there are many more people who are connected and we will have to share this presentation. First of all, and to relay Julia's comments, a big thank you for joining us today and to share with us this very key event in our history, in our company, because it's the emergence of a new brand, the emergence of a new company. Let me shortly introduce myself. My name is Pierre Boulet. I'm the CEO of both groups, Keplastics and Mecaplast, and the future CEO of Novares, let's say, after that call. I've been working 25 years in the automotive industry, half of them with French tier ones, and half of them with American tier ones like Visteon and Leo Corporation. I joined Mecaplast 5 years ago. It was very exciting because at that time there were a lot of things to do and a lot of challenges, and this is really why I jumped in. The goal today is to share some information about Novares and to talk about why we're there, what we have achieved, and what our plans going forward. So today is a great day. It's the emergence of a new brand. That means two companies, two brands, two teams are merging together under one umbrella, one brand. That brand is Novares. And I'm going to give you some insight about this new brand. Why did we change the brand? That's the first item. Even if the merge of the two companies have started early 2017, the fact that the two teams were working side by side is different than having one team working together. So we want really to have all the talents, all the competences working together. This is key to benefit from the capabilities of both companies. We're going to continue to work, design, manufacture, innovate in the automotive world and concentrate on plastic. So we're going to even more concentrate than in the past on what we do. So where do we come from? Two companies with different history, but some similarities. First of all, we have the same DNA. The two companies' DNA is to move from metal to plastic within the automotive world. And this will stay and remain the fact. Mecaplast on its side was created in 1955, that means more than 60 years ago in Monaco, by Mr. Charles Manny. He was a visionary, a pioneer, an entrepreneur, and he brought the company to a very high level already in the 90s and the 2000s. The company was focused on technology, and Mecaplast designed and developed many worldwide premieres. In 1960s, Mecaplast was the first company in the world developing a plastic fan. In the 80s, the first company developing a plastic cab cover. And today, we are making the first plastic heat exchanger, and this is the worldwide premiere. On each side, K-Plastic was born about 30 years ago in the US and has been very active in many countries. After US expanding in Europe, expanding in China, and they bought the Olo Plastic Company. Both companies had to face difficult time in the years 2009, and on the Mecaplast side, the FAA, means BPI today, became a shareholder of the company, and together with the founder and the family of the founder, the family Manny, helped the group to survive that difficult period. In 2012, I was called to join the group, and I had to pull many people from my team because it was not easy to attract people in these days. So I'm proud to see that today, nearly 100 of previous partners, previous team members are still in Novares. In 2014, when the turnaround of the company really started to materialize, we started contacts with Equistone Private Equity, and we started to share our strategy, our future, our view on future. And let's say that 2 years later, in April 16, Equistone invested in Mecaplast Holding and became our majority shareholder. This happened together with the BPI, who maintained his investment, but also the Mani family, and some managers also jumped in. In fact, today, more than 200 managers are shareholders of our company. That was a very significant milestone in the history of our company. This has allowed us to boost the internal innovation that we were having, and also has changed our plan on the external growth to allow us to have a bigger spectrum. After this period, so we could contemplate or look for larger companies, and this is how the idea to acquire a bigger group appeared. We physically acquired the shares of K-Plastic in December 16, but in fact, starting in 17, we are working to merge the two companies on the operational side. So it's really a merge that we are realizing today, to merge organization, to merge teams, to merge a way of working. And this merge is going to be a key milestone in our group. So what do we do? What are the products we are working on? We have structured our business into three sectors, business sectors, but in fact we have seven product lines. We do components for combustion engine. This is the top end. We also produce bezels and clusters. I'm going to go in some more details later on. Air vents and decorative trims, interior and car body trims, handles and openings, exterior painted and surfaces, and a brand new one that we launched this year. It is e-powertrain components for hybrid and electrical vehicle. So why do we change? Why did we decide to change brand? The big first need was internal, or is internal, to make sure that we do not talk about them and us. It is very important to merge a team and to give the sensation, the feeling that we are part of one single and unique team. So to have everybody working together, to enhance teamwork, to go on the same direction, to work with the same goals, I thought it was important to share the same name. And this is why we decided this change. Also, this will allow to go further in the synergies, whether there are human resources, whether there are sharing competences, but being under one umbrella is key for success. Externally, this is also very important, because we have started to talk to K-Plastic customers about Mecaplast products, but it's ever them and us. So to make sure that we only talk about Novares products, to give credibility to our single team message, we had to have a single name. So this will give visibility to our brand, and we hope this will attract talented people, talented resources, and that our message toward the customer will be better understood. The name and the logo, where did that come from? To be honest, I never thought it would be so difficult. The merge is nearly nothing versus changing a name and choosing a logo. First of all, you need to decide what kind of message you want to convey with your name. So you have to go with a specification and this kind of stuff. Then when everybody is okay, you need to choose a name that means this message, which is even more difficult. Then you need to have many people sharing the same idea, which is another target. Then you need to verify that this name is available, and this is another hurdle. At the end, we made a choice. So our name is Novares. I'm going to explain why it means, and it covers 75-80% of the group. That means It is everywhere except China, where we have still some legal issues to overcome. But I thought it was the best balance between timing and efficiency. So our name, Nova and Res, Novares, has two portions. The Nova is innovation, is new, and the Res is an object, a thing in Latin. And what we really want to convey is our ability to design and produce and deliver pragmatic innovation. This is key for us. We're not a laboratory, we're not a research center. We want to deliver pragmatic innovation. And our logo, the triangles, are really the components that we're capable to design. But Pentagon is starting to be the solutions that we provide. And all together, this is really what we want to deliver to our customer. It means an innovation that works. So the second logo motto that we have is we deliver more than plastic. We want to go beyond plastics. We do nice plastics, we do mechanisms, we do a lot of things, we do technical plastics, but we want to go beyond. Means we want to provide parts that are still replacing metal, but in some categories we want to overpass metal parts characteristics. We want to have parts that are moving. We want to have moving mechanisms. So we want to deliver more than plastics and go beyond plastics. Some key numbers about Novares. At a glance, Novares is a billion-plus company today with 10,000 people. We are operating in 21 countries. We can use a capacity of 42 production locations around the world. And as some numbers, this year we would have invested 80 million euro capex, and we would have used 80 million of tons of resins. We also have a very powerful R&D and innovation force. We spend around 6% of our revenue in innovation. We now have 600 engineers and technicians working for innovation and design. And we have now 12 engineering centers, 7 about skill, and 5 about tech centers covering the world. We're proud to do innovation, and we want to recognize our inventors. So we have a special program for that, and we have a portfolio of 142 patents today, and 55 of them have been filed in the past 3 years. So innovation is really one of our pillars for the today and tomorrow's development. About development and growth, we are very proud of our financial numbers. Not the only one, but at least these ones we are proud of. First of all, on the first phase, talking about organic growth, our organic growth over the past 2 years have been about 6%. 6% is about 3 times the average of the automotive sector. So we think we have the ability to generate a significant organic growth. If we add Keplastic on the top of that, between 2012 and 16, it is a growth of 80% that we are contemplating. That means over this period, we would have nearly double the size of the company. So we are very proud, and I'm very proud of the work of the Novares team, because this is really the joint effort between the Mecaplast and Keplastic team, because we need to add resources, we need to add talents to get to that point. Who do we work for? In fact, we deliver all major customers. You can list the brands from number 1 to number 20 or 30. We deliver the top 12, top 15 brands somewhere in the world with one product. We are proud about the balance that we could have achieved with the acquisition of Keplastic portfolio. Our French OEM represents roughly 30% of our portfolio. The US OEM is about 20%. The Chinese starts to be significant with a 14% total sales. This is followed by the Germans with 12%. And we still have 10% of our sales with Japanese. So obviously, when we will talk about future, we would like to expand our coverage with the Germans, the Chinese, and the Japanese OEMs. The second number we are very proud of is our order book. We calculate our order book with the customer numbers, but just for the coming months. And as soon as we start about talking about the future years, we use HIS or advisors numbers. When we populate these numbers, we get to a number of 5.8 billion of euros, close to 6 billion. This means if we have to deliver all the goods that are under order, it will represent approximately 5 years of sales. So today, we have 100% of our book order for 2018 and 95% of our order book for 19. This is very, let's say, important for our future. That means we have a secured future. And even more importantly, this number shows the significance of the trust that our customers have put on us for our reliable deliveries, for our competence, for our capacity to supply their plans. Together with K Plastic and with this merge, we now have a presence which is far better balanced. Plastic parts are not traveling well. That means we have to produce close to customers. And therefore, global footprint is a key factor of success, it's critical. And we have an outstanding production footprint that, if you compare to our peers, none of them can propose that to their customers. And we have a footprint that is shaped for our customers, and we have been awarded many, many global programs thanks to our footprint. So Novares is truly global, and for the first time ever, the Chinese population of Novares has exceeded the French one. And this is a sign we're moving, and we're moving fast in that direction. Here's our playground. From, I would say, Mexico, Detroit to Tokyo, this is where we are operating. We have a truly global manufacturing footprint. We have 42 locations in the world. We have 17 customer service centers, and you'll see in a minute we have 12 engineering centers, really well spread over the world. In total, Novares has more than 50 locations, whether they are production or engineering or sales. Our R&D force is really significant. We have resources ever in any place customer would have needs. We have our global innovation led by our several skill centers. We have one skill center per product line, which is key to concentrate innovation, know-how, and these people are responsible for answering to customers. And we also have 5 technical centers to produce local development, but also local service to our customers in these regions. Again, I don't think that any of our peers, competitors can show and propose such a network. Our DNA are these two products, interior, exterior, and engine products, and it's key for us to keep that balance. They have different financial characteristics, they supply different plants, and it's key that we keep that balance. So, when we want to do some cross-selling today with our customers, it's key that we can propose any product line in any plant. So we focus a lot of energy to make sure that we keep that balanced portfolio, and this will be key to generate opportunities. I'm going to move forward and quick on our product line. The first one being combustion engine. There are a lot of questions about combustion engine future. Is it going to stay? Is it going to die? There are a lot of announcements that by 2022, Mr. Ghosn will have 40 cars EV and et cetera. Based on survey that we got, based on many things, we think that gasoline engine will stay some decades before it gets to even decline. The first thing about diesel is that our share in diesel is about 25% of what we do. Total diesel engine represent 5% of the group turnover, and that means we supply 75% of gasoline. So each time a customer wants to shift from diesel to gasoline, in fact, we supply the gasoline portion and we're not really impacted. The second point is that in any hybrid engine, there are two engines, the combustion and the electrical. Therefore, as the hybrid powertrain is going to develop, we will have more and more combustion engine. They will have to be smaller, they will have to be smarter, they will have to reach a higher performance in a reduced space, and we are working on many projects in that direction. Bezel and clusters. This is a sector where we believe there will be a quick change, because behind that, it's all the communication between the occupants, not only the driver, but all the occupants and the car. That means instead of having a driver and everything around the driver, we think that in the future, there will be more and more devices for the occupants. So there will be more and more devices around and spread, and more requests for these communication tools. Tomorrow, there will be 2D, 3D smart surfaces all over the car. We may see them on the rear, on the front, everywhere. This is a big challenge for us, and we have a full team working on these devices. Air management is also a key product line for us. The next generation or air vents will have to comply between design and efficiency. We will see in the next generation of cars some slim air vents. The air vents we like to disappear behind the design. So integration of air vents and design is key. Therefore, our next prototype that I'm going to present in a minute will present our way, our answers to that request. But air vents and air comfort illumination is going to be key and a big request from customers in the coming future. Interior and car body. We think that with the autonomy, with connection, we will have more and more needs for the occupants to have devices. Everybody knows the old nice tablets, but today you have USB port, you have a lot of devices appearing in cars. This will require more and more devices, therefore more and more weight, therefore more and more request for plastic components. So this is why we are focusing on a premium interior car, and our biggest customers in that regard are BMW, PSA for the high-end, and other customers. Plastic mechanisms, handles. We produce millions of openings every year, including interior handle, exterior handle, and fuel doors. These mechanisms are integrating more and more functions. They are becoming more and more complex. Some of them are being automated. Therefore, and some of them are security components. This is where the knowledge of automation of Novares people is key, to be able to produce millions of these products with a high level of security. Plastic exterior and body shape is really another key area of knowledge and competence. This includes body color painted parts. That means we're capable to paint parts with the same quality the OEMs are painting their car body, because they just fit on them, already painted. We also produce ABC pillars, the ones between the windows and the windshield, but also millions of roof bars. Roof bars is an old product at Novares. It's a mixed product between aluminum bar and plastic feet. We're working on full plastic groove bars that we're going to show early next year. And we also presented this year foldable roof bars, meaning instead of having two roof bars and have to put two others on the top of that, we just flip them. Therefore, instead of having two layers of roof bars, you have only one. So this concept is presented and well received by many of our customers. Combining competences between interior and exterior, on our next prototype car, we're going to show exterior pillar. We would have integrated cameras instead of mirrors. We're going to send the image inside, and on our interior pillar, we will have integrated 2D screen. That means by the outside, you will just see the camera, and inside, you will have 2D screen. This means this will improve the air penetration of the car and reduce consumption. And by combining two product lines, we always provide better service and better solution. E-powertrain. This is the last skill center that we have launched. And we are convinced that maybe the electrical vehicle is going to be on the road in the coming years. But before that time, hybrid is going to develop by a far bigger number. First of all, because of autonomy, because of time to refill, because of many, many other reasons. But for us, it means a far higher plastic car content, because obviously we will continue to produce the plastic part for the combustion engine. But on top of that, we will add the hybrid plastic component for the hybrid portion. Therefore, we've had a look on the business, and even if the European car makers, even if the US car makers are making a lot of noise about electric vehicle, the country where the electrical vehicle is going to boost or is boosting is China. Nearly everything which has two or four wheels has a battery in China. Many millions of bikes have batteries that are on self-service in Shanghai, and you have nearly all the two wheels. In China, it's not a car manufacturer willing to build electrical car. You have one big battery manufacturer who is diversifying itself to manufacture car. So our Shanghai Tech Center has been promoted to a skill center and is starting to work with the Chinese OEM. And obviously, we will benefit from that knowledge somewhere in Europe and the US. But China is really the country where electrical vehicle is going to launch and to develop. This is a summary of our seven product lines. And you will see some more details about the families. And to make sure we are able to develop all these products, we have built a global development plan, global rules and tools to make sure that all the Novares people speak the same language and can exchange data. So by combining innovation, combining sales capability, we have developed a smart way of selling our products to all our customers around the world. So we have a dedicated development plan to make sure that we can service our customers in any region for any product. One of the bases, we are a technical company and we believe in innovation for growth. And we want to create value through innovation. So Novares is first listening to the market trends, so we integrate everything we hear. We also talk to our customers and understand what they want to have in their car in the future. But we also have sessions of internal creativity, and it's more than 1,000 ideas that we have collected in the last 2 or 3 years. And all that is bringing into a big mix, and we select the innovation we're working on. So we keep the target to have pragmatic innovation, innovation that can be seen, that can be touched, and that can generate value for the customer, but also growth for the company. And this innovation is real. In 2014, I have launched the SMT program. The idea is only, I would say, to put in a real car all the innovations that has been filed or discovered or homemade products that we had during the last 12, 14 months. We put all these innovation in a real car. So the SMT1 was launched in 2015, SMT2 in 16, SMT2 in 17, and we're going to show SMT3 next year under the body of a BMW X1. All our best innovation, all the KP products will be in the BMW X1, and we will show that car early 18, somewhere in February. And really the goal is to bring these innovation to our customer so they can see, they can feel, they can like, they can buy in these innovation, and they see they are real. And this is a map of our travel. We're organizing tech days at the tech centers of our customers, and we move our cars. Our cars have been shown in Mexico, they've been shown in Detroit, been shown in Turkey, they've been shown in Japan, in China, in any place where customers, and France obviously, any place customers have tech centers. And we're proud to see that we have a significant attendance, because in one day there are more than 150 up to 350 visitors in a day. The maximum was India, we had 350 visitors in one day. Out of the main output of these days is a collection of co-innovation program that we sign with our customers, and the latest one we had was the plastic heat exchanger with BMW for their future engines. And we also get a lot of RFQs and new requests out of these tech days. Going forward, we believe that Novares is well positioned to benefit from the automotive market, not only volume, but trends. And we are convinced that in the future, customers will differentiate themselves through innovation, but they will also need more global programs. And we're convinced that our footprint, our capability, is well aligned with customer requests. We are also convinced that in the future, there will be more and more devices in cars, and there will be more and more need to reduce weight. Today, we are replacing metal by plastics, and we are starting to replace plastic by lighter plastic. So this trend is going to be endless. With the new brand launch, we have updated our ambition. Our ambition is to be within the top 10 worldwide for each of our 7 product lines. This is where we want to be in the next 5 years. To achieve that, we would continue our organic and external growth. We continue our focus on our 7 product lines. We will continue to create value through innovation and invest in innovation. Obviously, operational excellence will be a must-have. And to make sure we can generate program and manage program worldwide, we will have to work with our smart governance system, which is our global system. Our new commitment to the industry, to our shareholder, to our employee, is really to stay close to our customers. This is what we call global proximity. It's proximity everywhere. We're going to pursue endless improvement in operational excellence, and this is what we call reliable execution. This is key for customer intimacy. This is key for customer trust. We're going to continue to invest in innovation, and this is where we find, again, pragmatic innovation. The ultimate purpose of this is to continue our profitable growth for the satisfaction of our customers, our shareholders, and our people. Here's a selection of the takeaway that we would like you to keep in mind. We are working hard on all these items, and there are more to come. We have a lot of upcoming events that are going to be key milestones for our company. So I advise you to keep Novares name under your watch list, because we hope that we will see each other soon, at least for the SMT3 launch, but maybe before. So this is the image that we would like you to keep in mind, and a short video is going to express our meaning about our logo and our message.